morning, everyone.
Really excited for being a part of this wonderful event.
Mm-hmm.
The first time, first ever Moodle MOOC in India. And really, I'm very happy that finally Moodle MOOC has arrived in India. I am Suraj Kumar, working as a technical analyst in Holistic Learning, one of our Moodle partners. I enjoy working on Moodle and have special expertise in Moodle development. Today, I would like to thank Martin, Moodle community, Jasvindu Singh, Moodle partners, organizing members, and all the participants of this event for giving me an opportunity to make my presentation here. I would like to tell a bit about my company, where I started my career and is still working with the organization, Holistic Learning. It is a Moodle partner since 2006 and is now enabling multiple various organizations of different domains to establish their e-learning environment via Moodle. We have a good team. Thanks for Holistic for giving us the ambience for next level development. During Holistic, we have got chance to work on different stakeholders, different clients of different domains. It was colleges, universities, publishers, corporates, business schools, and many others from government and non-governmental organizations. And these are some prestigious clients: Intel, Vodafone, Unisys, APJ Sathya University, BML University, KU, and many others. During my development career, we have developed so many plugins related to e-learning and to meet the requirements of different organizations. Whether it was social wall, just a Facebook-like plugin where students can share their content, can comment on the students, can like the post something. So completely a social learning environment in a Moodle itself. And I can see that Moodle is not now a teacher, administrator or student environment, but now it is organization is using this as a complete solution system. And they want everything in Moodle itself. I have many stories to share with you, but now I am going to discuss one story, that is the biometric integration in the Moodle for real-time attendance. So, first of all, we just think why there is a need of integration. Many colleges, schools, or organizations and universities are now using biometrics for employee attendance, but now they just want to have this system for the students also. So, definitely we need biometric integration in Moodle environment to check actual in-time attendance of students, to check whether proxy students are making attendance, or to set reminders if the students are failing their absence from either classroom or from a special proximity gates like hostel gates and campus gates. Yeah, definitely as discussed earlier, where is this useful? So this can be used as a classroom system for automatic attendance, automatic status of attendance, whether they are late, absent or present. It can be used at hostel gates to track the movement of students. It can be used at the examination hall to check the student status. It is a perfect sitting plan, and at the laboratories also. The integration architecture, this is more technical, and I just want to talk about it. Integration architecture is basically a way to explain how we are getting biometric data into Moodle application. Because every time getting data from remote server, because most of the time biometric data may be hosted on a different server. So every time getting data from different server and using it in a Moodle, it's not a good choice, because it may fail to show any data in case of remote server goes down or slows down. So better to keep those data into Moodle native applications. So we have two approaches, either database to database syncing approach or just write a script to get data from node server and put it into the Moodle table. So if anyone has interest in integration architecture, so we have special presentation on it and we can share it on our ballistic learning group. So definitely to implement this biometric system into Moodle attendance system, we need to have certain prerequisites, and these are venue management because we don't have venue. So first need is integrate venue with the biometric system, biometric machine, associate biometric IDs or IPs with a particular venue. A venue may be lab, venue examination or something. Access card or any biometric identification with the users. And the third one is database synchronization from remote server into local table, and this is not the required one, but we have a cost here, and this has certain advantages. So during implementation, we found that we have certain problems we got, and we approached with certain some workarounds there. The problem was problem of multiple punches. Students can even either intentionally or deliberately can have multiple punches. And exactly it is not most possible that if a session starts at 10 a.m. so all the students will punch exactly at 10 a.m. so there is a need to define certain thresholds so that the students can be just their punches can be made valid. One of the problem that we have with biometric data is it captures only in time. There was no out time. So we need to figure out if we have to send reminders with the student, still they are out. So we need to figure out in or out situation. And it is the common case of universities and colleges, oh, I am not coming, please make my attendance on behalf of me. So this is the birthday punching is a general case. Although birthday punching can be strictly checked with the biometrics of type of advice pattern or iris pattern or something else. But wherever we are using access card, it cannot be easily restricted. So there are some workarounds that we approached for our implementation. For the problem of multiple punches, we can ensure that only first punches will be allowed as a valid punch. We will define a threshold, suppose 10 minutes before the session and 5 minutes after the session. If the students are coming, they will be treated as present, otherwise they will be their status will be either late or absent. To check proxy students, they will plan a seating arrangement in the classroom or examination or some. The students will be forced to take their seat so that teacher or faculties can check whether the students are proxy or not. And in case of multiple punches, we have given an interface to administrator to ignore any punches so that a genuine student should not get any email alerts in case of absence. So this was the interface where we were setting threshold for the valid punching before the start session, 10 minutes before the session and 5 minutes after, and we can configure it at the site level, at the course level, and specific attendance level in Moodle. This is how we have implemented biometric attendance integration into Moodle. The venue management, the access card or biometric ID mapping with the users, syncing of biometric data, then use layout plan to implement seating plan, sessions for the attendance module, creating schedule with teachers and venues, organizing seating plan, automatic attendance status on the biometric data, and finally how we are tracing proxy students into the system. The venue management here, we are creating our venues here for every room. Even our guest class, hostel gate and campus gate are still available where biometric machine is installed. And we are setting for a special biometric machine, and we have trigger times here by what time the student will get alert or any defined authority, whether they are proctor or warden, they will get by this time. So we are setting here to define trigger time. So by that time, they will get email alert as a responsibility on students. This is the access card mapping interface where we can create a new access card name, where we can issue a new access card to the students and they can set their issue date and value up to date. This is the sample CSV file through which we can upload access card mapping in a bulk. This was the venue layout plan. So we can have different venues with different seats, with different arrangements. So we have their interface to define our layout. So I have defined here 30 seat layouts. Even we can define like auditorium to make such spaces empty for giving the space for stairs. So we can define layout of venue as per our type in the given parameters. This is the interface where we can create sessions for a particular courses from the start date to end date with a particular, you can say, for the specific weekdays with a certain duration, with a certain gap interval, we can create sessions for a course for a particular period of time, for a complete academic year. And this is the schedule with teachers and venue. You can see a student can get this information how my courses have been scheduled, and they can check at which teacher. This is the interface where we are scheduling our teachers to a specific venue, and a student will get this information on their calendar, and they have their separate interface to check their timetable in the Moodle calendar. So this was the interface where I am selecting the faculty and room number and scheduling particular sessions in Moodle. This is organizing seating plan for session. So I have already a room layout with us, and we already have the students of particular sessions. So only I have to drag and drop users and put them at their respective seat. So I can create a complete seating arrangement for the students in a classroom, and faculty or the teacher can check whether the students have seated at their respective seat or not in the classroom. Attendance status on biometric data. So we can see we all already have defined our threshold period for the module or for the courses, and we already have synced data from the biometric machine. So automatically student will get their status on the defined threshold. So if they are coming beyond the threshold time, they are absent. They are within the threshold time, they are present. And if they are beyond the classroom time, they are absent automatically. And even we can check the actual in time of the students into this interface. This is what we can check the automatic attendance status of students as per the sitting plan that we have created earlier for the session. So the faculty can easily check whether students have taken their seat or not. And there is an option report proxy. So if a faculty finds that someone is proxy here, simply can report proxy and select the students, and the respective concerned authority in LMS will get reminder that these are the students. And we also have system where students are penalized automatically if they are proxy students. We have some to-do plan here, like we have set this for a single geographical location, but we are planning to do it for multiple across geographical location, and we're just going to add time zone information with every biometric machine. Currently, sitting plan is made by the faculties, but we are now giving features so that student can just request for the sitting plan preference, and it will be finally approved by the faculties. We have right now the practical rectangular structure for the venues or auditorium library, but we are now trying to have a closer mapping of room where we can plan circular or semicircular classroom. This is in our to-do plan. And definitely if you have any questions, so just meet me at Palestine Learning Booth. I will be definitely very happy